Hey, in this video, I'm gonna be talking about how I got started investing in real estate. Hey guys, I am Mr. Maciek. Welcome to the channel, where on this channel, I talk about investing in real estate, how to be a better real estate agent, growing your net worth, and all investing. So if you're interested in those topics, please subscribe below. I would really appreciate it. All right, let's get into it. This is gonna be a little informal video of just me talking about how I got started investing in real estate. It was my early 20s, and here's what happened. I had finished college and I moved back to my parents. I came back into town. I studied abroad. And what happened was I got tired of living at home. So I started looking for rentals, and my dad dropped an idea that perhaps I should look at buying a property. So I did. I started looking at property with my friend's dad, who was a real estate agent. The process was very easy. He was very experienced and made it all painless. So we looked around and I found a condo. I was really interested in places that would be really big. I was not concerned about the quality of the property. So I found a property that was a rental for about 15 years. And at the time, this was 2002, it was listed for $55,000. And I put in an offer at $52,500 and the offer was accepted. So what was really special is that this was a 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath townhouse. That means that all the bedrooms were upstairs and all the living space was downstairs. So the master bedroom had its own bath, and then 3 bedrooms shared a hallway bathroom. Now, what was great is that I got into an FHA loan, which at the time needed a 3% down payment. Now they're only 3.5% down payment. So it's actually a very good way to get started buying real estate. And this was not an investment. This was for my own living, but I didn't really need 4 bedrooms. So after 6 days of owning the property, I ended up finding someone that wanted to rent 2 rooms. And it was excellent, because my whole mortgage payment was paid by this one tenant, which I called my roommate. I didn't know the difference between roommate and tenant at the time. So that place needed a lot of work. I did a big demo. My dad helped me out quite a bit. And after the demo, I started rebuilding. And that's when I learned that I didn't know anything about fixing things. So one by one, I started learning and learning. I bought these Home Depot 1-2-3 books. I talked to people at Home Depot and at Lowe's and at Ace Hardware. Those are the 3 hardware places locally. And I learned, and I just tried to do my best acquiring tools along the way. And I got that place fixed up pretty well. Now, fast forward just a couple of years, literally 2 years, and then I ended up finding another property, which was a single family home. And this one, I actually did a cash out refinance on my first residence. I took about $30,000 out and I put a down payment on the second property, which was a 4-bedroom, 2-bathroom house. Very big and spacious, really awesome house. I miss that house. And I had experience already being a landlord, so I quickly got into renting the bedroom. At any given time, I had 2 or 3 of the bedrooms rented at all times. And I took the master once again, and I rented the other rooms out. And here you go. Once again, all my expenses were covered just by all the tenants that I had living with me. So I was 25 or so years old, and it was great because I was just living with other 25-year-old people, and I made a lot of good friends, and really my whole mortgage was paid. It was a good deal for me. All the while, my other first property was rented, and I was profiting $200 a month on that one. And then I thought a couple of years later, I can do it again. So the market was hot. It was 2004, 2005. And what I did is, near the end of 2005, I ended up purchasing another property. And this one was a little more expensive. So first one that I bought was $52,500. Second one was $152,000. This third one was $256,000. So I needed quite a bit of down payment for this one. So I ended up getting a home equity line of credit on the second house. And this is really where my first mistakes, financial mistakes, really came into play. Because I took out this money and I knew how much I could rent that house for, and all the costs would be covered and that would be just fine. And then I ended up buying actually 2 properties. One was an investment condo and one was the single family home. But this single family home was small, just a 2-bedroom, 1-bath. And I lived there. It was my primary residence for a few good years. And here's what happened. The market crashed. I mean, quite frankly, a lot of people lost their jobs. A lot of people lost their investments. And what happened with tenants is that they stopped paying. And now here I am with 4 properties, 3 of them being rentals, and 1 of them being my home, and 3 tenants who stopped paying. And I had a series of unfortunate events that I didn't know how to dig myself out of. Here's what happened. One is my air conditioning got completely vandalized at the big house. That's about $4,000 or $5,000. I didn't have that money. Also, that same tenant that it happened with, but apparently he didn't do it, ended up trashing the place and flooding the place. It was horrible. So there was big expenses and he stiffed me on the rent. And I didn't know how to evict people very well back then. So I ended up actually losing months worth of rent. Nowadays, it's only like a month that I'll lose because I know how to kick people out if they're not paying. But back then I didn't know what I didn't know. So I ended up losing money here. And then the first property, I lost tenants, and then I had a situation with the association over there because that was a condo. And then this investment property, I was upside down on it by tens of thousands of dollars, meaning it was worth way less than I actually owed on the mortgage. And one day something happened and I gave up. I did have a job, it paid okay, but nothing excellent. And what happened is I gave up on the properties. One by one, I just said, I can't do it anymore. I was working 16 hour days, my regular job, and then trying to fix all these properties. And then once I did fix them, I rented them and people would stiff me and just rip me off. And I was just in a poor position. So what did I do is I gave up, I stopped paying, and I got foreclosed on. And that haunts me to this day. This is on my credit record, but it's been over 10 years. So you gotta dig a little deeper to see it. And it actually doesn't affect me anymore when it comes to buying property. But for many years, I was not able to buy or do anything unless it was gonna be private owner financing. So let's fast forward just a little bit and what happened. So the market started going down and down and down. And I had a friend who was interested in investing and thought of me to just talk to me. And I was very open and transparent. And I said exactly what happened to me and what I learned and what I know about it. And being that she didn't know that much about it, we got into business together. And very quickly, her family got involved, put in additional capital because they knew what was going on in the market. And we started acquiring properties in Sarasota. We formed an LLC and we were all partners, three of us. And then what happened was we started buying a property at a really, really good price because I am a deal finder. I love finding excellent deals, not just real estate, but all types of stuff. I just like deals. I like to make my money stretch. So as I started presenting opportunities, eventually we started moving on them. And you know, first one was downtown Sarasota, a nice triplex, beautiful property, excellent location. And that was our first start. So as we kept going throughout the years, we ended up purchasing probably somewhere around, I don't know, 20 to 30 units, rentable units. Some of them were duplexes, some were triplexes, some were single family homes. We even flipped a couple. And basically, we had a great cash reserve to buy if a deal came up. And at that point in time, there were many deals. Even though the market was down, there were still opportunities in this down market that were even lower. And we were buying some stuff from the prices of the 70s and 80s. It was excellent. Well, the arrangement we had was that for the first year or two, I would be training my friend and then she would take over all the management. And unfortunately, we had a change of life events. So that plan changed and I ended up managing everything. And I did that for years. In fact, I think it ended in 2018 is when we finally stopped that business. And I took over the business after we liquidated everything. And it was great because I got to learn throughout the process. Not only did I get to learn a lot about the local real estate market, about being a landlord, maximizing revenue and profits, but I also got to learn from their family, who are very smart business people. So I got to experience regular meetings with really successful people that kept me in check and really taught me how to run a business. So here we are as the years are going by and I'm managing all these different properties and having regular reports every month sent out to them. And it was a really, really good system. But it was a little taxing because we had a lot of very low income rentals. Ghetto. And it is what it is. That's what we bought. We bought things for $20,000, $30,000, $50,000, where everything else cost $100,000. Our portfolio grew and eventually we decided to break it up because the market had appreciated quite a bit. And during that time, I ended up also going and starting to buy things by myself, adding to the inventory that I would be managing, except I was 100% owner. all that experience that I got by working with them set me up for success in the future. Not that we didn't have success, we did have success, but it really taught me quite a bit back then that I could bring over into the current day. So I ended up acquiring properties, and then a year would go by and I'd get some more. And then half a year would go by and then I'd get some more, and I am still building my portfolio. At the current moment, I'm at 14 rentals plus my home that I live in, which does not count as a rental, obviously. I am still searching for great properties, great investments, because it's all a numbers game. It's not about if the market is high, if the market is low, or what the interest rates are. It's all about the numbers. I have yet to invest in other states, and I have bought properties sight unseen, but a lot of the stuff that I do is stuff that I can go see. I'm not comfortable yet going out to a different state and purchasing, not knowing the local market, the local laws, and also what it takes to be successful in those markets. So in a nutshell, that's my story in the real estate spectrum. I do other things to make money as well, which if you're interested, check out my channel. I'm doing an options trading challenge, which is really awesome. And I just launched a video yesterday showing unbelievable results. In fact, if I took all my money from real estate and I put it into this options trading challenge, my wealth would multiply. It is unbelievable, but I like to be more diversified. So anyway, if you are interested in, you know, fixing your credit, investing in real estate, investing in stocks, or just making money, then please subscribe. I would really appreciate that. Also, check out this video right here. Is that options trading challenge that I was just telling you about.